All right, welcome to the second hour of the show, and we're getting straight into the love letter. But just a quick reminder that we are live on social media, so of course, Urban Television on Facebook and at Urban TV Uganda on Twitter. Get in touch with us on our personal Twitter handles. Mine is at Ainedasha and Willis Daly, as well as Tina Fierce One. For now, getting into this love letter on this morning, they're saying that my fiance cheated on me with her ex. Mm-hmm. Hello, Urban Today. I have been living with my fiancé since 2014 and all has been well. We had planned for our wedding last December. However, last October, I discovered that she had an exchanging love message with her ex-boyfriend with whom she has a child. All this happened when I had traveled out of the country for 1 month, course in September. When I confronted her, she agreed that she had made a mistake once and she apologized, asking me to give her one last chance. I was devastated and called off the wedding. I strongly feel betrayed my trust because I have been taking good care of my stepson, providing everything up to school fees with the hope that she wouldn't go back to the ex-boyfriend for anything, but instead she went ahead to cheat on me. I have suspended many opportunities to travel abroad and make money because I have a feeling that she will cheat. Therefore, I feel we should part ways, but the issue is that we have two sons together. What should I do?
This man is still in a lot of love. One of usungu bwebu mumenya. Bwebu mumenya bwoka bwoka because, let me tell you how you know this man is still in love. Mm. They have two sons together, which means bweazala mumukazi ne stepson.
Well, I wouldn't want us to conclude like that. Enzo kubanga ababe babili ne stepson ngabo bagatwa mube basatu. Or maybe bali babili ngabo gambio uwe ne stepson.
No, by the looks of it, aliomu.
We have two sons together.
Yes, because he agreed. I have been
two sons together.
Stepson.
Maybe could mean two sons together.
No, what I'm going to say, it's really unfortunate, and I don't want to speak much on it. Because let's face it, everybody is faced with a unique situation. If your baby mama decided to backtrack and go back to her baby father, that's on her. I don't know why people want to believe that this man shouldn't even feel this bad. He shouldn't feel this betrayed or anything. Mm. If anything, this was the world showing him because clearly she still likes the other guy, but it's not your fault that she went and cheated. And again, it's not going to be, it will be your fault though if you stand hostage in this relationship like that. Because he's saying he has failed to go abroad and work because of this woman and he's scared she's going to cheat
again.
Baby boy, before you told her to cheat or before you were even scared that she would cheat, she went ahead and cheated. But she agreed and said, look here, I messed up, my bad, I'm sorry, it won't happen again. And from the looks of the text, he has not said she's done it again. Mm. So he is living in the fear of what happened, and you can't fault him either. Mm. But here's the thing, you either make up your mind and say, this is a deal breaker for me because I'm looking after another man's child, and then his father is banging my wife while I'm doing everything. It's a sticky situation. It's very disrespectful and it's hurtful. So it's up to him at this point, whether you want to sit down with her or not. If you're so could be taken aside, you as an individual, what is going to float your boat? That simple.
Would it be right for us to conclusively say that, you know, this this lady here, you know, had an affair with the ex because she still liked the ex? Or maybe it's one of those situations that happened and, you know, boom, you just realize
after it's done. No, there is no boom. Because one, he has explained, I look after my stepson. Mm. I feed him, I pay his fees, I do everything for him so that she had no need to interact with him. Do you get what I'm saying? Kuba mwana wa abali wa nomaka. Why would you go see your ex? You get what I'm saying? So if she went to see her ex, it's because she and her ex still have a situation. And if she was that dumb for a person who was going to get married in just a few, you found the one who is looking after you and your child, then it makes you understand the type of quality of person that she is. That's why I'm saying it's not his fault, but it is entirely going to be his fault moving forward if he decides on whatever he decides to do. Because if he says, I'm leaving her, It's going to break up the home.
He feels like, you know, they should part ways and everyone does their own thing and basically break up. But then on the other hand, because
they have two kids together,
there's a son involved, so he's perplexed.
That is what makes you see that he's actually very undecided. Trust me, omusajja omukowu oba omukazi omukowu bwako watomonyomeza ajabbi pakingamu akuviire. You will co-parent, you will do whatever. Tewali musajja ayagala kuliira musowaani ye atokateko okumumanyira olina musowaani ye ng'atalabirira n'omwana wo.
Willis Daily, gwe ensonga eno gyogera kwoki?
First of all, Jose, why am I dark?
You're ugly.
But you're ugly.
No, it's possible.
It's possible.
It's impossible. Ah, back to the love later.
So go take your single yoba kulabi. Eka yu singo yu wakulami. Weteleze
bulu. Teleza nyindo, Dennis. Dennis, zoom in and
what are you talking about?
Why is his nose shiny?
Katinga baga amba.
Is his nose shiny?
They had some men in Gogena.
Hey, you don't know. I can smile. But for me, for me, I'd say this. That first of all, let me just start in the middle of the letter. That when you're talking about your relationship with someone and then you're trying to tie a rope around their neck and say, after all, I do this. That is where the problem starts. Are you helping? Are you taking care of that boy because you want to show that you love the woman very much?
Or are you doing it?
Or are you doing out of the goodness of your heart? And that's a problem that most men in this relationship face. That you're saying, I'm paying school fees for that boy. He's not even my son. How come she cheated on me? What are you saying? These are two different things.
Exactly.
You have a relationship with the woman that is, you know, your fiance, you're planning to get married. The choice for you to take care of the son
is yours.
It should not be dependent on this one. It's different. You can choose to say, I don't know how to take care of him. He has a father. Or you take care of him out of the goodness of your heart. But when you take care of him because you love the mother, every time she does a thing, I'm taking care of your son. Every time she does this, every time she hugs a co-worker, you don't know, I'm taking care of your son. Why do you hug him? What's together? Banai. For a moment, we'll be the Dabana Gabina Nava.
Oh, man, I'm well, Chok, when you have a chimongere.
Gemazima. O to Kamucharo, Ngakana Kariao, a kid of Lavaria Mugezi, Nayavazad Divina fees. You take the kid rooms as we have fees, Tamu Bidi Sat, Mitwari, Tan Mukaga, send it as you want to need. But you're not taking care of that kid because you want a relationship with the mother.
You're taking care of the kid because
out
you want
the goodness of your heart.
Yeah.
So men in such relationships barely visible, you know, because they help and
never do la.
Yeah, never do la. So you need to isolate the two. Taking omwana taina cha koze. Even if you break up, you can still take care of the kid.
Exactly.
So manya the man may not have issues, but this kid is a Ugandan, is part of the society, and you taking care of them is helping society. So when you go to the cheating, I don't think this woman cheated. If she cheated, she would not have agreed that she cheated.
What did she do?
She wrote, she had a love message with the ex. Yes.
This is what the letter is saying. I have been living with my fiancé since 2014. Everything has been well. We even planned for a wedding last year. However, last October, I discovered that she had been exchanging love messages with her ex-boyfriend, with whom she has a child. All this happened when I had traveled out of the country for a month. That's, of course, in September. When I confronted her, she agreed that she had made a mistake once, and she apologized, asking me to give her one last chance.
Yes.
I was devastated and called off the wedding. I strongly feel she betrayed my trust because I have been taking care of the son, providing school fees, blah, 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 and whatnot.
Exactly.
But instead, she went ahead to cheat on me.
No, if you have your own get demo.
Is it your letter?
No, if you are cheating.
No, is it your letter?
It's just emotionally writing. But this guy's issue is there was a love message between his fiancé and the ex while he was away. That is the problem. That this woman might be, there are people who...
So you are trying to say that they may not have, you know, cheated.
They were just flirting.
They cheated with words.
Yes.
Yeah.
I miss you, boy. Yeah,
those things,
we
used to talk like this and
what
else. We just had to go there.
Are we ready to see?
Are we ready to see?
I tell you, I'm as Magali. You cannot avoid it. We all have exes, and some exes can want to get extra into Kulabanga, you're doing so well, they want to tap into that happiness. So they send you like a message, oh, I miss you, I miss the times we had. Katigali boy, you
fall.
No, kamula, get content. Hey, the good times, Katinamachi one kamu, that could be a love message. So when they read it, it's like, ha, they've started talking with the ex. So she did not cheat. If she had cheated, it was dumb for her to say I cheated. But I don't think she cheated.
Okay, I want to first say something. This is one thing that I want every man out there, in case you probably have fallen for a woman who has a child, or if you're falling for a man who has a child. When you get a partner who has a child, and that child has another parent, do it. Nchimani, in Africa, it is not abantu bachira banga akajoko. But please introduce the parent to your child, to your new partner. Put it on a leveled ground, because let me tell you, you are both parties going to be raising a child together, whether you want it or not, as a co-parent. You are supposed to introduce the other parent to the new partner you have. Basically, what this woman, why this comes about, imagine, Willis, if we are dating, I have a child, right? And then I introduce you to my baby father. I'm like, hey, baby father,
but
this
for
is...
What?
No, listen, because my child is in your home. Listen. It is out of courtesy. Listen, out of courtesy. It helps. Because if this man had met this other man, there is a sign of mutual understanding of like, hey.
The respect is there. Because this other man would feel like, after even meeting you went ahead to, you know, sleep
abroad,
with my woman.
Let me tell you, abroad, you are better off. No one in Kampala. I will tell you this because I'm co-parent.
I want you to hold that thought. What we are going to do, we are going to go in for a very short break. But when we do get back, we want to critically look into this letter and also understand where all this is coming from and what are the possible solutions we could give to this particular gentleman writing to us.